In this example, we have the integral of the fifth power of tangent of x divided by 3 times the square of secant x divided by 3 times dx. On the right, we have some notes. When the integrand function involves powers of tangent and secant, we shouldn't need these for this example. If we recognize the derivative of tangent is equal to secant squared, we should be able to recognize we can perform basic u substitution by letting u equal tangent of x divided by 3. But if we do look at the notes, notice for number 1, it states if the power of the secant is even, which we have, it's 2, save a secant squared factor and convert the remaining factors to tangents, which again, we already have one factor of secant squared, and everything else involves tangent. So we'll let u equal tangent of x divided by 3. Recall that tangent of x divided by 3 is the same as tangent of 1/3 x. And now we need to determine du. Du is a derivative of tangent of x divided by 3 times dx. Notice this requires a chain rule. The derivative is secant squared of x divided by 3 times 1/3, or 1/3 secant squared of x divided by 3 times dx. We don't have a factor of 1/3 in the integrand function, and therefore we will multiply both sides by 3, which gives us 3 du equals secant squared of x divided by 3 dx. And now we perform substitution. We substitute u for tangent x divided by 3. Notice this will be u to the fifth. And 3 du is equal to secant squared of x divided by 3 dx. Performing the substitution, we have u to the fifth times 3 du. Let's write that as 3 u to the fifth du. Let's go ahead and factor out the 3. We have 3 times integral of u to the fifth du. Integrating with respect to u, we have 3 times u to the sixth divided by 6, or 1/6 times u to the sixth plus c. 3 times 1/6 is 1/2, giving us 1/2 u to the sixth plus c. The final step is to replace u with tangent of x divided by 3. The final antiderivative is 1/2 times the sixth power of tangent of x divided by 3 plus c. I hope you found this helpful.